So in this part we will continue what we have left in the second part. So in this part we are going to make a hyperbole model of tennis table tennis racket. If you search for tennis table, especially tennis table racket, you will see these samples, and they are the same, but the only one which is different is the top view, which is has some different textures or some different yellow or wooden colors. And I will start from one which I have downloaded here. So I will start from this one, and this one it's exactly the same one we using in the game, but this one has some wooden different textures. And let's get started by going to our scene and enable background images and add them as an background image. And after just a moment, it's loaded to. So let's wait for a moment until it's loaded. So here we will choose this one, and let's say it will be in the top view only. Let's see how it looks. What I'm looking for is to make a hyperbole, which means we can go up to 4K triangles. And again, we will start by an a plane. This plane will be here, and the scale on y axis to be like this. And again, scale on y to be like this. So we are making the geometry first of this part and extrude on x axis, because it's symmetrical we can use the mirror modifier. Let's see if we can use it. So we will delete some part and apply mirror modifier around y axis, so we can use the mirror modifier. And again we will start to making and trace this correctly. Before you use the mirror modifier, you must be sure that this medium line it as the center to be everything is correctly at. And you can be sure by making an plane, each edges are aligned correctly. And if you add an edge loop here, you can see that the origin at the center. And if you added mirror modifier around y axis, you can see that it's which is mirrored correctly. And if you select this vertex, you can see that this isn't clipping, and you must sure that it's clipped to not go anywhere like this. So let's go our layer here, and we have reached to this part. Again we will go and extrude all the way. So as you can see, we must add some loop cuts here, and the more loop cuts you add, the more geometry and the more exact dimension the more exact shape it which you will get. But the high poly model you will get. So we have a basic shape like this. Let's see how faces we get. We have these faces, so we can move it here and move it here. So now we have tracing correctly the shape of this racket, and now it's the time. Let's see, we haven't enabled the clipping, the clipping, so we will extrude on X axis around this dimensions. And if you see here, we have some basic thickness around, let's say 1 centimeter, and we have this plastic. So let's go. We are in the top. So in the front view, we will select all and extrude on Z. Let's say it will be. We haven't. Let's remove doubles. We haven't applied the rotation and the scale, so we have here these rotation and the scales. So it's around 9 meter, and I have looked online and see that the dimensions of the racket is around a 0.18 centimeters. So I have opened this image to explain what I mean. I mean that in this racket we have two objects. This object, this one is this called the bed, and this bed has dimensions of 0.5 centimeter in this one, and in this. The length of this one and the height of this one. And again, this handle is around 3 centimeter. So if you are not sure, you can go online and say racket game, tennis game, racket dimensions. Let's see how for any of these ones. So this is, there is not dimensions, and let's return. What I mean of dimensions is to get the dimensions of the racket and for the specifications. So we have this one and this one. Up to this moment we haven't any dimensions. Haven't any dimensions. So let's see. And this racket also up to ages. So anyway, we can see if you didn't get any dimensions from your customer. For me, I have get 0.15 and 16 centimeter in the length, and for the handle you can get 3 centimeter from the handle, and the length is around 0.05 to 20 to which is 82 millimeters is around 10 centimeter, is around 8 centimeter. So this is what I mean. We have the pad and we have this handle. Anyway, let's get started by making the dimensions correctly. So I will make an plane. This plane, this plane has 0.160 centimeter and 16 centimeter, and let's scale. Firstly, we'll shift D and move it the trash can, and we will scale it. We will scale it to be like this. So I have scaled the racket to be exactly the same as this plane. So if you looked here, we have the racket to be in x-axis around 27 and in the y-axis around 16 centimeter. So let's try to extrude. So anyway, we will make some thickness for this racket. We will extrude on z-axis around G on Z, extrude on the axis around point 008 G on Z, point 005, which is 5 millimeters. Let's try, and again we have made this and recalculate normals. We will select all these ones and make the fiber cover, and the fiber cover will be at both sides, and we will select the fiber and apply mirror modifier, and we can call it to be fiber, and it has a small thickness around. After removing doubles, we have around 1 millimeter and a half. And let's see the final thing which we will make is this wooden part. So we will select all these faces one by one, and we can extrude or duplicate in Z axis and separate it, and again we can extrude on Z around 3 millimeter or 4. So if you have seen any racket, you can see that this part is down and this part is highlighted as this. Finally, we will make the final part, which is here, and this part has some indentation, so we can make it by moving here and add another part here, and this will be like this. Don't forget to make the origin to geometry, and we can apply the mirror, and again apply mirror modifier to be this one called main racket, and this will be mirrored around main racket. in z axis like this, but make sure, let's see, so we have some problem when we have so let's fix this problem first. And so this problem is made when we have make the mirror fire, so cursor selected and origin T3D cursor, and add a mirror modifier. It will be on y axis. Again, we will move this to be here. So we have make the top one and the top fiber, so we'll shift D on Z, and each one of these we will rotate around. So I will rotate it around X axis 90 degrees and move them here. If you can use the mirror around some axis, it will save a lot of time. Anyway, this is a tip to make it aligned perfectly here. You can use the vertex slide and vertex snapping. Anyway, we have perfectly make this racket. And let's try to texture it. As you can see, you can dissolve this edge if it will take some geometry. Let's try to dissolve, and anyway it can make here some circle, and I will leave it at it. So we now is the time at adding some subdivision surface. We have left of 2 vertex and the tries of 4. We will stick with one subdivision surface and smooth shading. Try to add some indentation here and some edge here. Again, for this fiber, we will smooth shading and add some edge split. And this one will be again the bottom one will be the same thing, and apply edge split modifier. Let's try to add and sub surf modifier to this top one. As you can see, we have successfully made the sub serif modifier for all parties, and as you can see, now is the time to texture this racket. Now we have 4,000 triangles for this racket, and you can see that it isn't suitable for a mobile game. But because it will be for the viewer, we can use one low poly for the other player and one high poly to pointed to the player. And let's see how we can texture it. So this one is a fiber, and this one has some flags. So we will select this one, and what I'm looking for is to select the outer edge like this, and this outer edge will have to be marked seam. So anyway, we will select all these seams, and as you can see, once you have unwrapped one item, you can apply them. Let's see how we can achieve this. The remaining one is to select these edges and the mark seam. Select all, make sure that you have applied the scale and unwrap. So let's see, we have now unwrapped this nicely. We have three items. Let's see, we have this one, we have this one which is the side, and we have this one which is the top part. So let's see where is the top and where is the bottom. So let's see, we have this one which is the top. So the top part will be this one which is in the right, and let's scale to make some margin, and let's try to make this. And this is the first part which will be UV. And before I do any step, I will go to the UV and make folder which is called racket. And now we will export this UV. Go here, and in the UV we will go to for racket and call this racket UV. And you can select must sure all UVs and make export. And after that, you can go to your folder and open it in Adobe or any similar image editor like GIMP or any similar image editor. And for a while, it's been opened in this file. So first thing, we will call it UV, and after that we have this one. If we are looking to make it exactly like this one, we must use some flags. So let's zoom in this one. This is the top, as you can see. We will say that we have here this place, here up to this. Let's try to transform selection and go here. again we will start a new layer and let's select, we have here this black color, and this black color will be go here and the black, start a new layer and transform selection and go here, and this one will be white and not pure white but F3 F3 F3. Again select these two layers and control J to duplicate these layers, and let's try to make the background to be something like this. We haven't duplicated the layers, so let's try to duplicate the layers and move the original ones to be in this place, and the new ones will be placed here. This new layers has flipped colors, so let's try to save this one first, and this one has the color of this white, and this one anyway, we have some space, and we can see that we will make some cool thing. We will make here this space and start a new layer, and let's copy this color which is red color, and we will go here and save. Make sure that it's aligned to what we have here. And make sure that this red color at the bottom here. And now it's the time to export. You can call here, right here, any. Let's wait. We can write here the name of touch game or so after you successfully paint your UVs, you have the ability to export this as racket, export like this, and save. Make sure that you save it to an BNG file, and let's go to our file and start new material. This material will be called and racket like this. We will start by basic mix shader, and this mix shader will be mixed with a glossy shader, and this glossy shader has this, so we can start by black or this blue material. We start by this blue one and mix it with 0.07, 0.09, and we will duplicate this mix shader again. All this one will be duplicated on the y axis. Add an image texture. This is image texture will be like this, and open this your PNG file. Make sure that you apply the color to be and diffuse, and the alpha will be a factor of mix shader. And now we can adjust the glossiness to be 0.05 and will be 1.6, and the mix shader will be, let's say it will be 0.09, and this will be Beckman for the distribution. Let's try to see how it looks in the material tab. As you can see, it's nicely UV unwrapped. You have the ability to change this color as you want. Anyway, we have UV unwrapped the first one. This will be a basic white material, which is mix shader. Point 1.2, and we have this fiber. This fiber will be different thing. It's the same thing. It can be diffused with less shiny, and this shiny can be 0.3, 0.05. We must say that this will be a black and has some bump to it, and it will be noise texture, and the scale will be, let's say it will be 3 point, and the strength 0.1. We can use it on the glossy, and we can increase the scale. This will be also the same as this one, and this one will be the same object data. And now we have successfully make this racket. As you can see, we have successfully make this racket. In the next fourth part, we will complete texturing all the assets in this game environment. See you in the next part.